Good morning. This is about the first exercise I've had in about 2 weeks, I'm ashamed to say. But enough about that. I'm on a little trek this morning through the Fermanagh woodlands, which is why I've been off this weekend. Even I get some time off. And maybe not a bad thing, because it's got me back into, if nothing else, a bit of physical activity since the lull of slim for the summer. I was saying that, I've just had a beautiful full Irish fry, which was very nice. So there's a little rumour that's been going around that you can now sleep in a snow globe in the middle of the Fermanagh woods. So I have come down here today to check it out and find out if in fact you can do that. Because if it's true, it sounds pretty cool. Although, if you're from Belfast, it's not exactly what you would call handy. It's probably the furthest point you can travel anywhere in Northern Ireland from Belfast while still remaining inside Northern Ireland. It's a good 2 hour drive down here. You're right on the tip of Lower Lough Erne, and in fact it's quite a strange little road you use to come through. I think you come through Kesh, but you actually cross into the Republic of Ireland for about 3 minutes on the road, and all the road signs change, and you're of course in the south, so to speak, and then a couple of minutes later the road crosses back into the north and you're back technically in Northern Ireland. And I think the only way you can get to this place, because I was studying this on a map, is to actually cross over into the south. And again, it's only Ireland this could happen, where you have to head south to go north, right? But that's actually the case. Just one little road brings you out here, and yeah, you have to head into the south on this road for a short space of time before you can cross back over and go north again. So Serena says, if I go into the woods today, I'm in for a big surprise. Enough about that, Serena. Cherie, good morning. Hopefully you're good as well. It's nice not to be on the radio at the weekend. John Kearns was doing the cool years this morning. Deputy Dave tried to do the cool Saturday show yesterday and failed miserably. Right, so let's find out what this snow globe thing is all about. I've been given this huge key, right? The size of that key. Key's the size of my face, which is saying something. I'm going to open this little gate behind me here with this big key. If I can get it in. No jokes, please. And here we go. Right, so another little windy pathway to continue. I'll show you this. There we go. And then, we're in the muck. You see me falling on the backside. One way to get the Facebook views up, I suppose. And then we negotiate a wee bit more of the swamp. And we head back here, like so. Over here, and there we have it. Yes, there we have it. Just behind me now, you can see we have found a snow globe buried deep in the middle of Fermanagh. How cool is that? It's where I slept last night. This new thing only opened up a few months ago. It's built over 70 acres of woodland down here on the tip of Lough Erne. You're miles away and secluded from anything, and there's a real tranquility in the air here as well. It's really nice, actually. You can barely hear a sound around from where I am now, but you've got this snow globe, or what they call as a bubble dome to give it its proper name. And the resort's called Lough Erne, by the way, for those of you who've been asking me. It's really very something special. Amanda, good morning to you. Samuel, how you doing? Thanks for shouting in. You're watching us nice and early on a Sunday morning. Karen, good morning to you. Judith, welcome to me to Fermanagh. We'll be allowed back, Judith. There's the question. Thank you. Anne says, poor Deputy Dave. Poor Deputy Dave, nothing. He's good for it. Chris, enjoying your day off. Yes, I'm having a good day, Chris. Had a great weekend down here, actually. Also shouting in, Anne-Marie. Sam, good to hear from you. Out in Australia, of all places, watching this. Yeah, you don't get this in Australia. You do get snakes. Not here. Had a 110 in California yesterday. Linda, who's watching out in the States. Could have used some snow. Summer, good morning to you. Anne sounds so peaceful. It really is. Right, so the name of the place, for those who are asking again, it's called Lough. This is not long opened. It's a huge resort. It's set on 70 acres of woodland. There's a very special spa here as well. It's like a sensory spa where you go on pretty much a spa trail, and it takes you around all these little sort of huts that have been converted into saunas, steam rooms, hot tubs. And the flotation room was my favorite, where they have this pool area which is obviously covered with salt, and you go in and you float, and it gives you that sensation you've heard about the Dead Sea and being able to float in the Dead Sea. It's the first time I've ever floated on water. Usually, as you could tell, I have been prone to sinking on water in the past. It was a really strange sensation, and strangely, out of all the places I've traveled, all the different places I've gone around the world, never experienced anything like that, and it's right here on our doorstep in Fermanagh. So it's really interesting, and something that's worth trying at least once, that sensation of just completely floating on top of salt water. It was really really something different. So that's the spa. It's about 2 miles from where I am. Here's the bubble dome, and as I say, I slept in this last night. I suppose this would be for the person a bit like me who likes the idea of camping but just doesn't like the idea of camping, and I think that's the best way I can describe it. So it is, to all intents and purposes, a luxury huge tent. I'm going to take you inside and just show you what it's got inside. So if you like the idea of ever coming out into the woods and doing that whole kind of camping, secluded, under the starlight experience, but you don't like the idea of flies and insects and creepy crawlies and a little two-man tent, which I must say I've never done, nor would I ever wish to, this is maybe for you. So we will take a little look inside the bubble dome. And as I say, these are really quite something. So secluded. I think there's 7 of these in total on the site, and then there's some holiday cottages and a couple of larger houses. The site also has tennis courts, kids play park, an airsoft facility. It's got its own kitchen, dining area where they serve breakfast and evening meals, and they have 4G and Wi-Fi as well, which is the main thing. Because let's be honest, where would we be without Facebook Live nowadays? It would be as if you've never gone anywhere without Facebook Live. So it's a little bit mucky here, just off the beaten track where I've gone. Socks are ringing, but sure, there you go. Right, so this is us round onto the path. I'll show you it from this angle. So there we go, nice little steps in. Little nightlight, which is nice. This path is actually nicely lit at night, but where you just saw me walk from at the beginning of the video, I walked down there last night and it was pitch dark, so you need a torch to actually see your way around the site if you do want to go out walking around here at night time, although I'm not really sure why you would, but some people do. So here is the entrance. You push this open and it's, like I said, a huge inflatable bouncy castle. All the air is coming in there, so you need to make sure that door is closed before you open this door, and then you're in the bubble dome. You can see my bed nicely made there. That's the way I'll be leaving it too. And the shower. There is a baby bubble dome shower. Had a lovely shower this morning. Nice and warm as well. There's something strange about standing Something really strange about standing in the middle of the Fermanagh Woods having a luxury warm shower. really nice in there, and I don't know where all the water, I think it just sort of disappears down under the ground there. You've got a hand wash basin, all your soaps and shower gels there. As I say, lovely shower. So you've got a your own ensuite bubble dome bathroom, which is really cool. And then you can see above that your bed literally looks out onto the night stars. Now, we didn't see much last night because, of course, lots of heavy rain, but that actually made it just as good to hear the rain and the wind pelting down when you're in this thing at night, rather than to see the stars. If you were staying for a second, third night, I'm sure you would hope to do a bit of stargazing, but just to be able to hear that rain crashing down was something really special. The roof last night, the bed below me, as you can see, looks right up into it. So you've got this whole 360 view in here. It's lovely. And the good thing as well is they've thought about people like me that like their home comforts, so you don't have to worry about going cold or anything. There are lots of heaters. So there's a lovely little heater there, which I've got switched on right now, even though I probably don't need it because it's about 20 degrees outside. Even though it's wet, it is warm. And then they've even got under bed heaters there as well. They've got one on that side and around this side. They've got one there too, and you can stick them on using this little device. Up to 2 hours they'll run for and keep the bubble dome really nice and warm. And if you're still cold after that round here, they got the electric blanket as well. But to be honest with you, be surprised at how quickly it warms up in here. And there wasn't much need for all the heaters. But suppose in the winter, when there's a touch of frost in the ground, it's into minus, maybe even snow as well, this would be lovely. You can just imagine it in the dead of winter. And there's enough heat in here to keep this little room warm. And even the shower room as well. Again, there's something that makes you think, out showering outdoors, I don't like the sound of that, I'm going to hate that. Actually, it was a pretty pleasant experience this morning. So definitely the best way to sum it up, for those who like the idea of camping but don't like the idea of camping, or for those who don't like the idea of camping but would like to give it a go, this is the sort of thing that maybe is for you rather than the old sort of traditional tent. Just give you a one little scan around. The whole thing is they don't want TVs, they don't want radios. So you can see I've had to bring my iPad in. There's your torch. If you do want to venture out at night, you need that to see your way around the facility. But they've tried to keep it as true to the woodlands as possible, so that you do have this kind of sense of being secluded in a wilderness miles from anything else. And they've done such a great job at it. Even the theming, the way they've built these huge four-poster beds within the dome is quite remarkable. It's very snug, very cozy. I love it. I thought it was a really great experience. And again, one of the things I'll say is that sometimes you travel to all these faraway places for really great experiences, and there are little hidden gems like this right on your doorstep. So I'll head back out again. It's very funny. It's like being in a huge inflatable, because if you don't close this door first before you open the outside door, the whole thing goes down on you like a bouncy castle. And that's not such a good look. So I'd rather not be stuck in it. It's nice to be in and sleep. Don't want to be stuck in it. So there it is. That's the bubble dome. That's how I'm spending my weekend in the Fermanagh Woodlands. I'd certainly recommend it. It's the place, again, for those who are asking, is called Finn Lough. So look it up, give it a little Google, check them out on Facebook, and look into staying into one of these. You could certainly enjoy it. And I think, you know, each one, I suppose it's more of a couples thing, really. There are some bigger facilities on property, but these domes will typically be for two people. I think there's maybe a premium one. I believe there is a luxury one. If you've got more dough than I do, which is probably anybody else listening, and the likes of Deputy Dave and so on, he would be able to afford the premium one. There's a luxury one, which I think is a little bit bigger, has a few more facilities in it too. But listen, well worth checking out. Thought we'd give you a little show around that. And I'm off for the next few weeks on a few more travels as well, so make sure you keep an eye on my Snapchat, Instagram. We'll be checking in from a few places over the next couple of weeks, which are a little bit further afield than Fermanagh. So we'll catch up with you soon. Have a great weekend, everybody, and stay safe out there. Bye bye for now.